Odoo 18.4 has landed, and it's packed with powerful new features. From dynamic AI prompts and revamped planning views to easier project scheduling and improved file handling, this release is all about making your everyday work smoother, smarter, and faster. Let's take a look. Let's start with AI. Craft the perfect emails with just one prompt, complete with dynamic placeholders that adapt to each customer. Odoo's also getting smarter with your vendor bills. Now, when you import a bill, even if it's in XML format, Odoo checks for a PO number throughout the whole document, even if it's not clearly labeled under an order field. The bill is then automatically matched to the corresponding PO. And here's one for accounting teams. If a junior user posts an invoice, it's automatically flagged to review. Senior users will see it right away, highlighted and ready for validation, either one by one or all at once. In the Documents app, you can now open and preview text, XML, HTML, and a bunch of other file types. And it's easier than ever to send attachments from the chatter to the Documents app. Just a single click, and it's sent to the My Drive folder. In Discuss, you can set yourself as online, away, do not disturb, or completely offline. When you're in do not disturb mode, notifications are turned off and incoming calls are declined. Dashboards just got a major facelift. Global filters are now managed using the search bar, making your workspace cleaner and more intuitive. And you can now jump in between months by using the arrows or set custom dates more easily. And easily switch between bar, line, and pie charts and jump to a full screen chart in a single click. Live chat now comes with its own dashboard, so you can keep an eye on ongoing conversations, see where your team's overloaded, and adjust coverage on the fly. Inside each chat, there's a new info panel that tells you everything. Visitor details, internal notes, and even conversation status. It's all right there to help you prioritize and respond faster. And if someone forgot to ask for a chat transcript, no big deal. You can now send them a copy with just one click. In a list view of grouped records, the group has its own action menu that can be used to edit the grouping field. You can add a new stage by using the link at the bottom of the list. When you import records, like contacts, for example, Odoo now shows you the newly imported items right away. From there, you can use the breadcrumb to return to your full list. This makes it easier to understand exactly which records were added or updated. It's now possible to handle partial payments for quotations via the customer portal. Your customers can also pay the full amount right away if they choose. Say hello to three new payment providers available in Odoo. Plus, payment methods now copy over in multi-company setups. Managing projects has just gotten much more efficient with project templates. Let's create a template for our software development projects. We'll create stages and a new task. For this task, we need a developer and a business analyst. Now, when choosing this project template, we assign the right people for the project roles, and the tasks are then auto-assigned to the correct users. In the calendar view, we can now see the tasks that need to be scheduled and schedule them with a single drag and drop. Let's check out our Gantt view. With the new task dependencies buffer time feature, we can choose to keep the buffer between tasks as a safeguard against delays. And if we make a mistake, we can just click the undo button to revert the change. Managing our schedule is much easier now. We can now easily create multiple shifts. Let's choose the days we want and select a shift template. Just like in Project, the calendar view has been revamped in planning too. Create multiple shifts by clicking the plus button, select the template, and add as many shifts as you like. To wrap up our calendar view updates, let's check it out in timesheets. Just click plus, set up the details, and add timesheets to any day you like. In e-commerce, new design styles are available for displaying categories on the shop page. Let's switch it up a bit. This looks good. We can also preview the product variants directly on the product card, so our clients can easily see what the product looks like without opening the page. And for products that come in packs, we can also sell different packaging units. We can also choose between different layouts for the main action buttons of the checkout on the product page. The Barcode app also got a boost. Now you can add custom instructions for your operations, and those instructions pop up automatically when scanning. In Sign, we can now import documents from the Documents app directly into Sign. One click is all we need. The interface of Sign has been revamped to put focus on the most important information. And when sharing documents from Sign, we can now add an expiration date to add another layer of security to our data. Speaking of signing, we can also sign documents directly from the chatter. That's right! It means you can sign documents from any Odoo app. Let's ask Eli to sign this NDA. And while we're in employees, here's something exciting. A versioning mechanism has been introduced. If we want to check where our employee was, let's say in 2010, we can see all their work, resume, and payroll information from that point in time. And we can easily view employees' certificates in a new tab. Processing payroll has just gotten much easier. Batches have been replaced with pay runs, which allows us to process payroll steps with just a click. Moving on to spreadsheets, we can now collapse and uncollapse rows and columns in dynamic pivot tables and filter numbers by criteria. We can also pin side panels now, which allows us to work simultaneously in different panels. Last but not least, spreadsheets are now fully usable on mobile devices. Let's be honest, replenish on order inventory routes were a bit of a hassle to set up in the past. From now on, you just need one click to enable MTO routes in your database. Once the product using MTO routes, like this lovely cabinet here, is sold, the corresponding manufacturing order or purchase order is created and linked to the sales order with a smart button. Batches and dispatches have also been improved, and we can also organize our delivery orders from the map view, just with a drag and drop. Handling perishable goods is going to be much smoother now that we can see the expiry and removal dates on the forecasted goods report. In purchase, we can now import sales orders with a single drag and drop. Check this out, it's complete with lines, discounts, sections, and more. The new forecast-based purchasing feature allows us to make smarter decisions when replenishing our stock. Odoo automatically suggests the number of products we need to purchase based on actual demand. No Odoo yet? No problem. No client is left behind. If they don't use Odoo, they can import the sales order in an XML format directly from the customer portal. When creating new buttons in Studio, you can add tooltips. When creating a new button, for example, you can add the text for the tooltip, and when you hover over it, your text appears. And Odoo's ever-growing list of industry packages just got 5 great new additions. Event management, accounting firm, floral shops, real estate agency, and bowling alley. And there's plenty more to explore, so be sure to check out the full release notes for the complete list of improvements. Try it out today and let Odoo do the heavy lifting.